Blackhawks with a short two-game Western road swing that begins tonight in the Valley of the Sun. This is the Gila River Arena where the Hawks will match up tonight against the only team in the league that has not won a game yet. Fisher dropped it. They're able to maintain control. Now a long feed. Finds Fisher into the Hawks. Got a two-on-one. He cuts in, trying to center the pass. Blocked it. Went in. Osterley blocked the pass. And it's stuck underneath Corey Crawford. A pass attempt winds up in a goal, and it's 1-0.
Fisher, you mentioned the Chicago native, scores against the team he watched growing up. He makes it a 1-0 hockey game. Ben Connaughton in the penalty box. An opportunity for the Blackhawks in their power play.
Now we'll leave for Taves. He'll snap it off. Saved to me. Now went right in. I don't know whether that'll be Panic's goal or not, but Jonathan Taves initiated the shot, and somehow it dribbled through Domingue and into the net. The Hawks on the power play have tied it up.
You see, down around the hash marks, the defenseman or the winger might be right in your face. Instead, he finds some space and some time, and he makes Arizona pay.
And it's a sharp. He's checked. DeBrinket able to get it back. Threw it in front there. Rudolph. Good save by Domingue. Jan Rudolph, a great setup from Alex DeBrinket, who again makes something happen when he gets the puck. Dropped it back. Duclair to the middle. Put it in front. He's a quick shot. Off the cross, and then the goalpost. He got enough of it that Connaughton had a great look. But Corey Crawford got enough of that bid to deflect it to the goalpost. All right, here's the attack by the Coyotes. That was not much of a shot. Taves flips and has the races on. Will Kane get there? Kane's gonna get a breakaway right to the goal. He scores! Jonathan Taves from Patrick Kane. He was alone from center ice in, and the Hawks are in front.
As we often see after a shot block, Patrick Kane will sometimes head out over the blue line, and he was wide open.
Now Bowman and Wingles, he's gonna get right to the goal to the backhand. Penalty coming. He was taken down, awkwardly crashing to the end boards. And it's going to be a penalty shot. Tommy Wingles up the gut. Stick handles. Oh, the net. He scores. Wingles undressing Domingue, who thinks there should be no goal. The referees are going to confer.
Domingue thinks that's the first shot. You're not allowed to take a rebound attempt, a second shot.
Yeah. Oh, you can only do it once.
Right.
The Arizona goaltender makes contact with the puck. We have no goal.
All right. They're going to say he did touch it.
Good read there by the goaltender, Corey Crawford.
Right off the draw, here's a shot, rebound, they score! And the initial shot was blocked and it laid there for Keller, I believe, to tap home. And a possibly fortunate bounce for the Coyotes has enabled them to tie the game. Hits the line. The line has had a big night controlling the play. Seabrook, a long shot, rebound, Domingue trying to capture it, it's still loose. And Panic couldn't find the handle at his feet. Knocked away and held in by Keith. He'll try a long shot. Chip, oh, what a save. Domingue, rebound, they score! Last Boma with his first Blackhawk goal and put his team in front lane in the third. And the Hawks' fourth line come through to grab the advantage.
Off the goalie, he spins around, takes it on the forehand into the empty cage.
Keller was driving up the middle. He's got it back and shot it. That hit his own man block and deflected wide. Cleared up the board, Goligoski had it, lost it, Wingles picked it up. Wingles, who thought he scored on a penalty cut earlier, now scores with an empty net. And the Hawks up two in the last minute. So it might not have been an oil painting, but the Blackhawks do get the win. And a frustrated Arizona team will remain winless. But there's a big part of the story, Corey Crawford and the penalty killing.